My name is Yodasa Williams, and I'm here with my debut novel called The Goddess Twins. It's a young adult fantasy about identical twins who discover their goddesses when their mother goes missing. And I'm telling everybody it's a black girl magic adventure. And yes. I'm publishing with Spark Press. I'm gonna read a section now about the part when, you know, I always love in, you know, coming of age and finding yourself stories when you find the mentor and they're like, this is who you are. So this is when the twins meet their grandmother, who's an immortal goddess. Gran's eyes shift through so many colors, indigo with yellow, hazel green with flashes of orange. They finally settle to a dark, dark blue, like the depths of the ocean, before she speaks, dropping the patois, as she says, that's not the real question you want to ask me, eh? You want to know why I spared my husband's life so long ago? I'll answer, but together. There was and has been, for so long, a war within our family. It was started because of the blessing that the fates and the celestial beings gave to me and my daughters. But you must understand, there's always a curse along with a blessing. And the stronger the blessing, the stronger the curse. While the women in this family grew more powerful, your grandfather too became different, darker, corrupted by evil and greed. The parts of himself that were once loving and vulnerable were eaten away to nothing. I tried my best to save him, to love him back to himself. But evil grows and infests in the heart, seeping into every corner like black mold. There's nothing to slow the growth once it's taken hold. My husband was particularly jealous of Celine, as she became the most talented goddess in our family. I snort as Gran's eyes turn to an acid greed like sour apple. The lack of respect you continue to display towards your mother is highly unbecoming of a goddess in training. I know you have experiences that lead you to think you know her, but I know who my daughter is, and you will listen with an open mind and respect that I have insight that will help you and Arden save her. I gulp, my face boiling from the tell-off, and nod. I'm sure Lilo is gloating, but I don't turn away from Gran's green eyes. After a beat, her eyes fade back to gray. She nods, satisfied I've received the message, and continues the story. Celine's first child was a boy. She named him Zion. He was bright and strong and handsome. Zion was about 15 when he started displaying some talents of his own, the first of any men in our family. He was always strong, but overnight he became superhuman strong. He was always charming, but suddenly girls were literally threatening suicide if they didn't love him back. It was early 1920s in England, and everyone noticed a black man with that much magnetism, and not in a positive way. Her eyes grow dark gray, and I feel the table tremble slightly. What happened to Zion, I whisper. Flashes of red swirl in her eyes, and anger enters her voice for the first time. A man accused Zion of attacking his daughter and confronted him in the street. Zion tried to reason, but the man only wanted blood. When Zion fought him off easily, dozens of men jumped into the fray, attacking him with everything they had. He had strength, but he couldn't take on a mob by himself. It was savage and brutal. He barely made it home before he died in Celine's arms. Gran brushes a tear from her eye. We raged and mourned for weeks. Celine was, there's no way to describe a mother at the death of her first and only child. My husband went missing at this time, and we assumed he was searching for answers or enacting revenge. When months passed and he still never returned, we started hunting for him, fearing he also met a tragic end. She sighs and closes her eyes. But we eventually discovered that my husband, Celine's father, had helped spread the hateful lie that brought the end to Zion's life. My jaw drops and I hear Arden gasp. It was the worst time in any lifetime I have lived, Gran said. To lose my grandson and watch my daughter spiral into madness, all while knowing the evil scheme was brought together by a jealous man I had loved for centuries. Celine nearly died of the heartbreak. Over a decade passed and we never found any trace of my husband. Celine barely ate or slept for years. She eventually lost the ability to speak. The weight of her grief was unbearable. She refused to let anyone shoulder it with her. To communicate, she would write letters, poetry, observations about people. But focus, you have barely begun and have far to go, my rebel Yankee girl. Thank you.